Here's an overview of Euler's method for solving differential equations of this form. The derivative of some unknown function x is just a function of x. And we assume that we know the starting value of this function x. So this could be temperature, this could be position, could be anything. So we start, we need to choose a step size. That's a choice that we get to make. And we'll start at time t equals 0, where we know the x value. So then, using the current value of x, the equation, the differential equation, this function tells us the rate of change. So we know how fast x is changing. We then use this rate of change to determine the next value for x. This is the current value for x. This is how much x changes in a time interval delta t. This is a little bit of make-believe. We're pretending that the rate of change is constant for this time interval delta t, and we can use that to figure out the next value of x. Then we increase t by delta t, and we go back to this step, and we figure out the derivative again. The derivative tells us how to go forward a little bit in time to figure out the next x. Then we update time, figure out the derivative again, move forward to figure out x. So 2 and 3, these are the key steps here. We're constantly shuffling back and forth. The function, the differential equation, tells us the derivative. Here we use the derivative to figure out the value of x. Then we go back, x gives us a derivative from the differential equation. We use the derivative to figure out x, and so on. So one repeats through these processes until you have enough of a solution. So in practice, one would choose smaller and smaller delta t until the solution curve stops changing. So if you chose a delta t of 2, and then 1, and then 0.01, and 0.001, doing this on a computer or a spreadsheet, and eventually one would see that your table of values, if you plotted them, your x's would stop changing, and that would be an indication that your delta t was small enough. So this is Euler's method in a nutshell. It gets at the heart of what the differential equation means. The rate of change is given by the quantity x. We use that rate of change to figure out x. So again, we're thinking of this as a dynamical system. It's a rule that specifies how x changes. The rule is written in terms of the derivative, the rate of change of x, rather than x directly, but not a problem. Euler's method or things like it let us convert from rates of change into the function itself.